This massive floating stage was built for just one performance, a music light and laser spectacular billed as the biggest event of its kind in history, expected to draw 2 million people to the Royal Docks. Its star, Frenchman Jean-Michel Jarre, will now be taking his considerable talents elsewhere. Just 10 days before the scheduled concert, Newham councillors have said it can't go ahead.
I think there is such a gap between the attitude of the Newham people in the streets who supported this project so much since these last, I would say, 12 months, and the attitude of the council yesterday, totally negative and totally... And I really consider that they went back on their word.
And he's not the only one who's angry. Local people, fearing Newham would slap a ban on the concert, organised a last-minute petition urging them to think again. They claim councillors didn't even look at it.
We want to build the borough up, and this would have given a great lift to an awful lot of people in the borough. I live just there. I would have been right in the middle of it, but I would have sacrificed the weekend of not being able to get out just to give a lot of people a lot of pleasure.
Seats were already going up along the length of the dock for some of the hundreds of thousands who had paid as much as £30 for a ticket. Thousands more were expected to flock to the area to see the fireworks and laser show light up the sky for free. When the axe fell, English and French crews had already been working on the site for nearly 2 weeks.
I felt angry and disappointed and angry.
But Newham Council say they had no choice.
We regret very much the disappointment, which obviously is being caused to many people who look forward to what would have been a very attractive event. But I believe they will understand that the safety of everybody at that concert was in jeopardy, and on that basis we couldn't allow it to happen.
The concert's promoters say they could challenge Newham's decision, but they won't. The seats are coming down and the hunt's on for an alternative venue. People are being told to hang on to their tickets, but one thing uncertain tonight: you may still see Jean-Michel Jarre, but will you be seeing him in London? Barbara Long, Thames News.